What is up, legends? Another week, another hype watch. We are back, and we got a bunch of stuff to actually talk about, both mobile and PC. So let's get right into it. Right off the bat, Towers of Asgasba. This game actually looks amazing. I was issued the email for this earlier in the week, and I was like, oh, I gotta get in on this one. This looks like one of those hidden bangers that just come out of nowhere, like, and it's just there. Like, look at the thing looking at you while you climb up on it. Vibrant world, obviously gonna have like survival and stuff like that. Just feel like you can just escape. That's what these types of games do. They make you feel like you can just play something else for a little while. Like not play something else, but be somewhere else for a little while other than this world and this planet. Like, man, it just looks great. I'm letting it rock so you guys could, damn, he fish like that. I wish you could fish like that, just be shooting stuff like this. Wow, those things are nightmare. That's nightmare fuel. Jeez, y'all can leave the hand things out the game. Anyway, next up is Puppet House. Speaking of nightmare fuel, whatever reason, obviously, because it's not even for a reason. It's Halloween season, so all of the spooky games are out and about and trying to get you to come through. This is just another one right now, only $14.39. It actually comes out. Wait a minute. What's today? It's already out. So it has a positive right now. This was yesterday. Yeah, it's already out. All right, so has a positive review right now. 19 positive reviews right now. And yeah, so you know, check it out. Might be something to your liking, not that expensive. Next up is Romancing a Saga. This was a press blast. You see, I'm on the press hub right now. This didn't log in. But press hub right now, press blast. I don't have any kind of thoughts on this, but I wanted to actually mention it, obviously, because, you know, I'm supposed to, that type of thing. But yeah, rock it out. And, you know, maybe, just maybe it'd be something that you like. I was never really a Romance and Saga fan. I'm more Final Fantasy. But there was one that I did play that I was, like, hooked. It was, like, amazing. I can't remember which Romance and Saga it was. But you had so many different paths and so much different stuff that you can do in that game. Like, I was legit playing that for months. Like legit months, and it was a really good game. Like I forgot what grade I was in school or something like that, but it took a lot of my time to actually get through all of that game, and I eventually got to the end and I got all the endings and everything else. This was before guides, before like any type of, like, this was before AOL actually. Like, well, AOL actually just started, but there was no guides on AOL. Like, you got no help basically. I think this might be the Romance and Saga that I played, and this is the remake. I'm trying to figure that out if that's the case. I just remember what I did in the game. I don't remember exactly the character, so I would probably have to watch a video and see if I can remember if this is actually the game, because if it is, I'm gonna get it. Okay, so next up is Sophie the Echoes. Again, another horror type of based game where, you know, like it is realistic and creepy, and the storyline is basically they made her husband go crazy. They took a kid, and now she's there. She being woman power now. It's coming out the 28th, and it looks pretty good. So again, you know, have at it. We just had Silent Hill come back, and it's amazing. Hopefully, this could be along those lines of Silent Hill. Next up is Wheel of Fortune. This is another amazing looking PC game. Spirit Mancer. I don't know where I got Wheel of Fortune from. Spirit Mancer. Bro, look at this. I won't play this game too. They got the demo right. I won't play the game though. I'll probably rock the demo just to see how I feel with it. Because sometimes stuff look good and it don't feel good. And that's unfortunate. I got me this new sponsor, Xbox. a Red controller that is amazing. It feels great. Like, it's good in my hand right now. This feels perfect in my hand. Like, Xbox makes some good controllers. I wish they made good games. Sorry, Xbox, but it's what it is. But this one definitely looks like it's going to be lit, so try it out. We have Slay the Princess Pristine Cut. All right. As you can see, this came out yesterday. And this is another one of those creepy slash... No, we don't want the sound to play. One of those creepy slash... As you got thick. The saying. Slash... action based slash story on based... No, rock it out for you guys. You saw the hand stuff and all that going on. I like the way that the art is in this. It's different. It's the hand-drawn art put together and the different scenes and stuff like that. I like that. I like it when it's different. We don't always need the same type of game all the time. It's fun to actually have that type of stuff. Next up is Queen Dizzy herself in Guilty Gear Strive. She's one of my favorite characters in other Guilty Gears, so I'm gonna have to come in and try her out. And her animations is crazy, and she's a queen now on top of that, and got the kid, which is Sin, who already actually came out already. And the cool thing is she has more control over her two pets, which are like a part of her, which you see them there, like Undine and I forgot the other guy's name. And she just looks great. That animation right there, right? Look at that, Queen of Compassion in full bloom. For it to just be Queen now, that's crazy. We got Venom next, and then Unica, and then Lucy from Cyberpunk, which is just a far out there reach. And she's way off too. We ain't gonna see her for a while. I'm interested in what they're gonna do with her, because it would have made more sense for Rebecca to be there. But I mean Lucy's the waifu bait that everybody like all the cosplayers and everything else. So I guess that's the thing. David would have been a good thing. Hopefully David is there at, like, if she gets a stage, like a Cyberpunk stage or something like that, hopefully they put David there, but he should have actually been in the game. Maybe Adam Smasher. Next up, we have Stellar Traveler, which I actually put up on the channel. I want to put it out here again right here, because this is actually a really good game. It's making a lot of waves right now, a lot of downloads and stuff like that. People are really liking this game and want it to actually be global. So I want to reiterate it again and put a link out there for you guys so you can try it out. Mobile side again. Soul Idol two sides of girls. No, another idol game for you guys to maybe look forward to. It's probably going to be along the same lines. But it looks like they put a little bit more into this, hopefully. Because there's too many of them right now. Like, you can literally go over to app support and then literally, you hit similar games, 1,000 of them. Not kidding, 1,000. Here's something different: Ocean Keeper Dome Survival. This actually looks pretty lit, and it's available for you guys to actually try right now. I'm actually going to try this right now just to see how it is and see what kind of. It looks like a little bit roguelike. Which you may not hear roguelike, I'll be in there and like got a little mech going on here under in the ocean and stuff like this. So we're gonna try to get something up on the channel right now. It just recently came out. So you know, something for you guys to rock out. You won't see it on my channel until after this video, which is hype wise on Sunday. So you probably see a Monday or something like that. It's probably not gonna make the weekend because there's a lot going on right now. Legend of Kingdoms Idol RPG, another idol again. And obviously it's gonna be the Wushu type of feel. Again, available for download right now. It's 50k downloads right now, which is pretty good. It just came out. So that's pretty lit right there. I have not covered this on the channel yet. So you know, just something for you guys to try out. Mini Empire Hero Never Cry. Wow, that is a name. Why they always do the Never Cry stuff? It's like five games like that, not Devil May Cry, but just other games like that that has a particular name. Anyway, city builder slash idler. Get the gist of it. Next up is Phoenix Contract. This is not out as of yet. I actually didn't know anything about this. This was actually an email. Somebody said that they got into beta and showed me a little bit of video on it. It's another idle RPG manager type of game, but they were showing me that you can control, you can attack and all that type of stuff, and more so a little bit better than just a normal idle game. So it's up here, go. Next up is Dragon Village. I actually registered for this a while ago, but it popped up on Google Play as in like one of those install when it's ready type of things. So that's meaning that this is about to come out. I don't know anything about this. I just I saw it and saw it's vibrant. We might as well maybe be cool, maybe something for the kids, stuff like that. But this is one definitely is coming soon. The Dragon Odyssey, the dragon theme today. Here we go. They got some good art. This all look like World of Warcraft characters. It's still good art though. Still looking like World of Warcraft characters. No, we'll see. Oh, we're gonna do all this character creation and never see the character. So, you know, we'll see. And then finally, before we get to the last two things for the hype of the week, see, this is the thing with this game, and I feel bad for Tarry's Land. Because of the new season and everything else like this. This literally was like supposed to be World of Warcraft Mobile. And it would have been okay if they did not get in the way. And for whatever reason, companies like to get in the way. They started doing things and putting stuff behind monetization. And can't do that. You can't do that. So I don't know if there's going to even be anybody to play this game right now, or if people even still care to play this game right now. I thought it was a pretty cool game for a like this, you know, mobile version of World of Warcraft. That's literally what this game was. But you know, I'll probably look at the new season just to see what's going on, because I still have it installed. I just don't do anything with it. You know, kind of again, just to see what happens, because I do like my character that I had on there. I thought that was fun. I thought the storyline was actually pretty good too. It was cheesy, but I thought it was pretty good. Like, you know, done as far as the stuff that you can actually interact with. It actually felt like World of Warcraft as far as what the way that the story was. It didn't have all the cinematics the way that World of Warcraft does, but it felt along those lines. So if they learn to get out the way of the game, maybe it'll be something. Or it could just be too late, because once you lose the public, you just lose them. Next up is Starseed. This is officially coming out. Yeah, on 6 days, officially coming out on that time now. That's going to be Halloween, and that's pretty amazing. That's pretty amazing, because it's going to be one of those games where it's going to be waifu based. Let's go into media. Definitely waifu based. The characters are turn based. Yep. I think you get her free early. He's a fun character. Obviously, waifu. Ambrosia. I mean, obviously you like they gonna put her out there to let you see all of that. It's hella loud for no reason. You know, to me it's a fun game. It is a 100% fun game. Is it going to be like crazy, like, no, epic? Oh, this is just a song. Is it gonna be like some epic 7, like we gonna be going crazy type of things? Nah. We're not doing that. It's a waifu type of game. She got mahjong. She laying on the mahjong table. She wants to play mahjong with her. With her body. That's what that's implying. Again, more waifu bait. And then they even give you a little peek right there for no reason. Let's see. What's the peek? Here go another peek. Dark skinned waifu. I never did get Ilya. But all type of hip. Even the preview is hip. So yeah, that's all we got going on for that one. So finally, speaking of hips and looking and everything else, all right, so this is Terrarium. This is by people who used to work with Decay and Shift Up and stuff like that. They're making this particular game. Obviously, it's going to be mech, waifu, jiggling all up in your face, firing bullets. I kind of wish Nikkei would do stuff like this. Like, just let us control the girls and run around, kind of similar to what Snowbreak does. I think that's the that's where Nikkei needs to go with that type of stuff. Let us control it. Just let us control it. Like, let us could run around with Rappy and be badass and all that type of stuff. Look at this. This is amazing looking. That's kind of fun. This looks like it's going to be fun. There ain't no reason why Nikkei can't do this. They're probably not going to, because that what like, they have literally like 40 chapters of you just sitting there looking at them booty shaking and fire bullets. Like, so I don't think they're going to do that. Like, maybe if they made Nikkei part two, that'll probably do that. But I think that the, that would necessarily, no, she is knocked out. She got bunny slippers. That's funny. And then you got them said they like, this is obviously going to be a banger too, which brings me to the last topic. Something, and there's a pet peeve for me, like with the industry and everything else. I wish the public would just be real and tell the truth about something. Before we go, you guys noticed the new Lara Croft that's on Netflix getting a lot of flack because Lara looks too buff and everything else. Says, I think she's fine. Like, I'm not in any like, I don't really care either way. I just want to see Lara run around and be the baddie that she is and do good. Lara was never supposed to be a little twig. And I think that was just in people's heads. She was never depicted that way. Even when they put her on magazines and even when they had Angelina Jolie play her, Angelina is just Angelina from back then. And obviously she had the boob out and everything else like that. Well, not out, but you guys get what I mean. But Angelina wasn't a weak woman. Like, and she's not a weak looking woman. She was still muscular too. And she looks along the lines of Angelina. So you telling me Angelina is ugly now? According to, like, that's what I don't understand. The public. Here's the thing, and I want you to think about this. What the public needs to do, and not just any one person, but people, they need to start, and we need to start holding them to this, is that all they want to see is jiggle. That is the only thing missing from that character in that show, is that she don't jiggle around. She's not like Nikkei, like right here with, you know, Stellar Blade and all that type of stuff. She's not like Eve. It's over. She don't jiggle around. That's the only thing missing from that character. If that character had jiggle motion, you would never hear any of that stuff. Nobody would say anything. If she ran around just like, damn, that girl thick with booty wobbling and breasts moving while she, like, she doesn't do that. She's just a fit woman. She has it there, but it don't wobble. That is the only difference. And what the public needs to hold everybody accountable for is that's all they want to see. That's what they want to see. Stop making it seem like, stop trying to use woke, because I literally ban anybody on my channel the minute they say woke. You better not ever say woke on my channel, because all woke means is basically people hiding behind that word to either be racist or hiding behind it to actually, if they don't like something, say if they don't like women, it's woke. Look at this woke game. It got women in it. We don't want a woman lead. Like, bitch, what? Like, who started this? I will play a woman lead in a second. Like what? Like that's all a woke is. Like, that's why I immediately ban anybody who says anything like that on my channel. You're banned immediately. Like, but you won't even finish putting the K and E and woke before you catch the ban. Like, just don't do it, because that's all that word means, basically. So it's weird to me that that has taken over a lot of stuff, and it's gotten so weaponized to the point that we can't like anything with women in it. Basically, if they don't jiggle, they don't like it. And then if it does, they don't like it. Remember what they did to Stellar Blade? I'll let that run back. Remember how they acted with that? The only reason why it didn't fail is because Stellar Blade is just an amazing game. They tried really hard. That's how you know it's BS going on in the world right now when it comes to, like, you know, reviews and anything else. Public, there's bad actors that all get together and try to mess it up for everybody else. They're doing it right now with Etheria Restart, where they're out here talking some nonsense, talking about it's just a it's a Hoyo clone and everything, HSR clone and everything else like this. I want to point out to you guys, if you remember when Honkai Star Rail had come out, what happened to Honkai Star Rail? It was a Final Fantasy clone. It was that nobody, we don't care. It's a Genshin clone. It's going to fail. Nobody wants to play this. Like, why? If I want to play Final Fantasy, I go play Final Fantasy. What happened? It make more money than Genshin now. It's the number one game, gacha game right now. This is why all that stuff is BS. All of that's BS. It's always like people just run around trying to grift to get views and get people on their side so people can see them and if they like their posts when they raging, fake raging, by the way. And they're doing it now with Etheria right now. Like, I've been pimp smacking everybody who say that nonsense and showing them, like, bitch, I bet you was the same one saying that Star Rail was gonna fail. I bet you right up there with Star Rail. I bet you spent like $1,000 on Star Rail right now, you fake ab. like shut up. Get out of here. It'd be so much nonsense going on. And like, don't fall for it, y'all. Don't let it happen. People will sit up there and ruin all the fun for everybody. We can't have fun doing anything anymore, hardly. We can't just play a game. A lot be playing a game, people be mad. Like, you should stand for, you should go shut up. Like, that's what you should do. Like, this game is woke. Your mom is woke. Go say hi to her. She misses you. I don't care. Like, I'm going to play the game. Like, anyway, that's all I got for you guys right now. You're gonna watch me say that on social media. Watch it go viral. Cause when I be flaming those people and firing them up, look at my Twitter. I be going after people on Twitter. Like, when they be saying stupid stuff like that, like, and they be going viral and it's funny. Because they don't expect anybody. They especially don't expect the creator with some type of popularity to come after them. But I be coming after people because they be saying stupid stuff all the time and think and be unchecked, and I'm like, no, you're getting checked. Catch you guys next video. Peace. Thank you for watching the video all the way to the end. Please like, comment, subscribe. I love everybody who stops by. You guys always make my day with your comments. It's always funny and whimsical and gives me a reason to keep going. So be legendary, and I will see you guys soon. Peace.